I just watched 2 hours and 20 minutes of Resident Evil 6. Oh my god. It was terrible. And I forgot, like, I knew it was terrible. Like, it was one of those things, like, I remember, like, I knew it was terrible. It was kind of like, I had seen it when it came out, and I was, like, aware that it was terrible. But you go back and watch that 13 years later, and it's just like, what the fuck did I just do to myself? So, and how this started was I was listening to some of the stories that I wrote. I listened to The Last Recruit and The Uncomfortable Conversation, which those two stories tie together. They're like, The Last Recruit is the story of Wesker recruiting Chris for STARS. And The Uncomfortable Conversation comes directly from Resident Evil 6, where basically Chris and Jake have this conversation about Wesker. What the fuck did I just spend 2 hours and 20 minutes watching? Because it was a lot. It was a lot. It was so fucking messy. It was messy as shit. And I forgot how fucking messy it was. Like, by the end, I was just like, I hate it here. But I'm sitting here laughing that I hate it here. Because I was appalled at the amount of messy that actually really, honest to God and truly, it was messy as fuck. And I'm just like, what the fuck am I watching? Like, I can't even begin to comprehend everything that I saw. But I do remember, this is what sparked my abject, like, utter ire for Chris Redfield. Because in the beginning, before he gets his whole goddamn team murdered, that Finn dude was all like, well, Chris is so awesome. And Lilith, I was just like, oh my fucking God. I'm up here doing what I call the frustration bounce. My frustration bounce is when I see something so upsetting that I can't verbalize it. I just start bouncing. I hadn't done the frustration bounce in God only knows how long, but that hit me frustration bouncing back to back in like the first 10 minutes, and I was like frustration bouncing. Oh my God. I am appalled. Appalled at how messy that was. I think my brain tried to psychologically block that out, but then I like fucked it up for myself by watching that again, and now my brain is like, see, now we have brain damage, now we have slight brain damage, and there's nothing we can fucking do about this, because you went back and watched some shit that you knew was a train wreck, and you watched it anyway, and it's just like, oh my God, hold up, dogs in here be thinking they own stuff, but... Like, oh God, I forgot where my train of thought was, but yo, that was messy. I'm ignoring you, by the way, Miss Ma'am. But yeah, it was messy. It was super goddamn messy. And I'm at a loss of words. I completely forgot how fucking messy Resident Evil 6 was. But when I put it in context, 5 and 6 are what I term the we don't fucking know years of Resident Evil. Meaning, they didn't know what to do with Resident Evil after Shinji and them dip from Capcom. Although, like, a couple weeks ago, I found an old LiveJournal entry where they were like, Shinji was actually working on Resident Evil 5, and then they took him off the project and shoved him over to Clover Studios. And then after they shut Clover Studios down... which will never get another god hand, but whatever. But after they shut Clover Studios down, that's when he and Hideki Kamiya both dipped from Capcom. But those 5 and 6 are literally Capcom's we don't fucking know what to do with this series. Especially, I will say, especially Resident Evil 6. That just looked like they were like, throwing everything at the fucking wall to see what would stick. And none of it stuck. So, and it's baffling me because I'm like, Resident Evil 6 is what got me back into Resident Evil. But I had to sit and think about that while I was watching it because I'm like, why the fuck was this messy piece of shit the one thing to get me to go back to Resident Evil? It was because at that point, Metal Gear had broke my heart and busted my balls. So I was like, fuck it. We'll just go back to Resident Evil. I just latched on to Resident Evil for the messy fucking situation that RE6 was. But yeah, you could tell Capcom had no fucking earthly idea what the fuck to do with Resident Evil. It was evident. And they were throwing everything, including the kitchen sink, at this shit. And it was just, it was a fucking, it was messy. It was so messy. And then the Simmons thing, which I already remembered the pants bit, but then it got even more hilarious after seeing that happen again. And I'm like, this man in these fucking pants, they just keep going back to being pants. Now, granted, they were tattered, but he still had his pants on. Then he dies on that pointy thing. And then, like, all his blood was going everywhere. And then he turned into the Umbrella logo. I was just like, I can't. That was when I lost my fucking mind. That was where my brain shut the fuck down. It was like, okay, bitch, you only got enough intelligence to run your vital organs for the rest of the day. You are not going to have conscious fucking thought after this because you done put me through this bullshit twice. Oh my God. I guess I gotta go somewhere and figure out my problems, because I'm telling you, that was a mess. That was, and then, like, when I think about Resident Evil 7 and 8, and yes, I am aware, we are not fans of Ethan Winters. We don't give a shit about Ethan Winters. However, I will give them some play for doing, like, going back to their roots, because, yo, Resident Evil 6 is so fucking messy. I can't even believe it. It was, and the thing is, I had already experienced it back in 2012, but I had to experience again in 2024, and it did not get better. In fact, it got a little bit worse considering 7 and 8. Because it was, like I said, it was very obvious. Capcom did not know what the fuck to do with this series, and they were just throwing everything. And throwing everything at it, you accomplish nothing. So, that fucking happened, and I'm just sitting here like, the fuck did I just spend almost 2.5 hours watching? But, oh my God. That is all I have, and I gotta go rebuild, because I'm all fucked up. Later.